This video will introduce you to NVivo, and it's a perfect place to start if you've never used the program before, or if you need a quick refresher. Here you can see I have the new version of NVivo open in my computer. I've got a list of all my recent projects, the option to create a new project, or the option to open a sample project. Whenever you're starting on your own research, you'll click New Project, but because I'm demonstrating the program today, I'm going to use a sample project. So, clicking on the Sample Project Multi-Method button will copy a 100 MB sample project file to my computer, and this is a perfect way for me to experiment with NVivo or learn about it in more detail. You'll see it's opening up straight again with a tour. As I'm going to talk through this program with you now, I'm going to click Skip Tour so I can show you it right now. You'll see the NVivo interface is split into three main areas. Two of them are visible now. So on the far left hand side, we have the folder list. Here I can see things like my data folder and subfolders within that, like files, file classifications, and externals. There's also areas for coding, cases, notes, sets, queries, visualizations, and reports. I'm not expecting you to know what any of this means at this stage, it's just important that these are where all of your folders sit. If we look at the data folder, for example, you'll see I can click onto files, and this will let me open up to see the subfolders within here. Of course, when you start a blank project, this is empty, and these folders just represent the way in which these researchers wanted to divide their data up. It's more normal to divide your data by the source type, which is why we can see here they've got area and township, within which they've got aerial photography, and they've got GIS output, which is short for Geographical Information Systems. In the main area and township folder, there's also some photographs. If we look in interviews, we can see they have textual interviews, they have video interviews, and they have audio interviews. In this literature folder here, there's an example of a journal article which has been brought in for analysis. In news articles, we can see some data imports from a newspaper website. And then under social media, you'll see there is a data set from Twitter. And a survey that they have imported as well. No, it's very rare that any research project will have this diversity of data. But again, this is the perfect way for you to see all of the different kinds of things you can bring into NVivo. Because this is an overwhelming number of sources, I'm going to head up here, right click, and close all but this particular textual interview to get us started. If I move down to the codes and then the coding, coding and the codes folder, you can see these are the different codes that these researchers have identified in the project. A code can be a theme, an attitude, a behaviour, a topic, a concept, a feeling. It's whatever you're looking for in your data. And you can see for these researchers, they've got a big focus on environmental change in the Down East area. They're identifying things that people have said related to the economy, to the community, to the natural environment, to real estate development. If I were to be in an interview like this one with Barbara, I might want to, for example, highlight this phrase and code it under sense of community. When I've done coding an entire source, I can use the coding stripes to explore where that coding is in context. As I scroll down, the stripes will show me where those coding references are. So for example, looking at this paragraph here, I can see there's coding to real estate development, there's coding to the natural environment, coding to infrastructure. Scrolling across, I can see coding to positive sentiment, to water quality, to negative sentiment, to the theme of balance, and to mixed sentiment. Already you should be able to see that we're starting to get a depth of analysis that is just not possible to achieve with a pen and paper technique. Another really important thing with this kind of social data is your ability to differentiate speakers. So for example, there are some things here said by Henry, the interviewer, and some by Barbara, the interviewee. To be able to help divide who said what, NVivo has something called a case. Cases are your units of measurement. They are the people, the places, the organisations, the events, the companies, the schools, the businesses that you are looking at. If we look in this project, we can see while there are numerous different examples of cases, one of the main units they're using are their interview participants, including Barbara. And if I look at my coding stripes over here, I can see every time Barbara has said something that has been coded to Barbara the case. And that means there is a version of Barbara in this project which is just her words. It doesn't have any of the voice of the interviewer within it. While this isn't particularly helpful for us as humans to understand the conversation and the interaction that took place in this interview, it's a really important way for NVivo to be able to analyse data. So when we ask it a question like, what are the most frequently used words by interview participants, or how is this theme explored, we can actually do it based on those participants and not necessarily the questions that we asked them. Furthermore, we can add attributes to our cases. If I explore Barbara in a bit more detail, I can see there's loads of information such as the township she's in, the community, how many generations down east she is, her age group, her gender. These are really useful values for the researcher to later be able to query the data, and we'll revisit that very shortly. It's possible to explore all of those attributes as well in the case classification sheet. Here we can see in one very big screen everybody's answer to those key attribute questions. The reason this looks a little bit messy is it also includes the survey respondents as well as the interviewee, so there's an awful lot of data in this particular sheet. Next up, let's look at queries, one of the more exciting functions of NVivo. It's really important not to get overwhelmed by queries or run into them too soon. The most important thing you will always do with your research data is coding it, reading it, understanding it, and going through that iterative process. Queries are good for us to get some quick answers, sometimes to look at our data in different ways and to visualize the coding that we have done. There's a load of different options in here, but I'm going to just very quickly introduce you to a couple of queries just so you get a feel for what they can do. Let's look at the text search query. The text search query lets us look for a word like fish and see where that occurs in our project. So we can see the word fish appears in 23 files. I could, of course, have just narrowed this down to maybe just look at where it occurs in our interviews, and that now goes down to just these 10 files that the word fish appears in. I can look at the individual references using the tab on the right hand side, which will show me where the word appears. So for example, twice in Barbara's interview, and it shows me some of the context around. When I get down to Charles's interview, I can see this is part of the question from the interviewer, and then obviously a number of responses from Charles as well using the term. I can also visualize this in a word tree, which shows me every word that has ever occurred in the search terms before and after. I can click on one of these trees to see the words through and be able to read across to see what happened. And if there's something I want to investigate in a bit more detail, I can double click on that phrase and NVivo will find that particular reference in context. And of course, I can go to the full source, in this case, Margaret's interview, to see where that was mentioned. In this case, it was a question from Nancy, one of the interviewers. Another query we can use is the word frequency query. I could use this for example, to see which are the most frequently used words by our interview participants. And this time, it's really important that I use those cases. So I'm bringing in the named case interview participants. If I brought in their entire interviews, it would also include the questions that the researchers have asked, and that would really skew our data here. So if I really do want to look at the most frequently used words, I really must bring in just those cases. And I can then visualize this output to get a visual representation. The bigger the word, the more frequently it was said in the project. And I can also use the options at the top of the screen here to alter this visual. These can be quite a popular way to quantify things without explicitly allocating numbers to them. The final query I'm going to show at this point is the coding query. The coding query is perhaps one of the more powerful but also complicated queries. It lets us ask very complicated and detailed questions of our data. I can add multiple layers of logic to, for example, search where people were using a positive attitude when talking about the natural environment and only in instances where the cases person gender equals the value female. As I run this query, it will find all positive references to the natural environment from female participants. I could then switch this over to male to see the positive references to the natural environment from male participants. I might next explore the negative sentiment about natural environment from male participants. You need to be really confident with your data and your coding to be able to run this kind of query, but I think it's a really lovely example of some of the real powerful ways you can explore data in this program. The very final thing I wanted to show you is just that NVivo does let you also map your data using project maps, and I'm just going to open up one of the existing ones down here just to show you what this can look like. So here there is a project map that is a visual representation of the final coding structure. Here we've got a concept map that shows the complexity of views on development. And then finally, a mind map where the researchers have thought about some of their initial coding. This video has very quickly gone over numerous functions within NVivo. There is absolutely no expectation that from watching this you would be able to undertake any of these queries or processes yourself. This is the first video in a series of videos that will go through NVivo.